Right, guys. Hopefully everyone's doing really well today. My name is Janie Angeli. I am a person that has experienced cancer, specifically Hodgkin's lymphoma, and that's why you're here today to ask questions. Well, we need to first of all give a giant thank you to BrightBot, who put us together today, and the whole experience that is BrightBot, which is allowing you to go to their website, video record any questions that you have about a superfluous amount of ailments that you might have, cancer-related, AIDS-related, anything medical. And what's great is that you are not just going to get some sort of handwritten response. Someone else is going to send you a video or do a video reply. So make sure you go to the website and do that. It just gives that personal touch that makes this all a little bit easier instead of just some written response. So with that, again, my name is Jeannie Angeli. I am not a doctor at all. And today I am going to talk about living a normal life. That is probably one of the hardest things that we can do while going through cancer. So how do we do that? Well, first of all, we need to realize that cancer doesn't define us. It's just something that we go through. And it's that problem where we try to make it define us. Yeah, it fucking sucks. Cancer is absolutely terrible. But there's so much that we can still do through our day-to-day lives that allow us to get through this absolutely horrific situation. So we can mope about our worst experiences of our lives, or you can actually live through them. So once you realize that cancer isn't just the whole of what you are, it is just something. So, all right, that's great. We got our mentality defined. Now what do we do with that? Well, let's make a plan. And who's the best person to make a plan with first? Your doctor. So, Janie, why am I making a plan with my doctor in order to live my life? That's a very good question. Well, your doctor controls your chemo schedule, honestly, and you can ask your doctor not to schedule chemos on certain times. For example, I had a bachelorette party, a wedding, my birthday, and something else, and the entirety of the summer that I was going through cancer and on chemotherapy. And honestly, I didn't want to feel like shit while I was supposed to hang out with friends and family. And so I made a plan and planned around the things that I wanted to do in my life. That is the one thing you absolutely have control of. So why wouldn't you do it? Like, it is taking a hold and being in control of yourself and not letting cancer control you, not letting the chemotherapy control you. So first of all, make a plan with your doctor and make a plan to live your life during this whole process. This isn't the whole thing. It's a tiny bit of time during a certain period of time. And around that is the rest of your life. So, next is plan to have fun. I'm gonna get rid of that. There's a lot of things that you can do while you are going through chemo. And I think I did the majority of them, I would have to say. I went to the extreme, and I went skydiving. Yes, I made sure I checked with my doctor to make sure it was okay first, but it was a warm summer day, and it was more than fine. Like I said, I went to a bachelor party, and not only did I do that, but it was to a bunch of vineyards. And you better, like, damn know that I drank a bunch of wine while I was at those vineyards. No, I didn't go crazy, but I allowed myself to take part in that social situation, because why one, why not? And two, the worst you're going to feel is regret for not going. Even if you can't, even if you are a little bit sick or not necessarily feeling well, having that time and experience and keeping things as normal as possible is so, so very, very important to do with your friends and family members. So with that, I also like went to a wedding. And I made other fun plans, like a Sunday fun day where a friend of mine, we chose a day and did a day of firsts. So everything that we did that day, we had never done before. And one thing was just simply going to a new restaurant. And another was going to see a sunset on a beach. I know it can be difficult or seem ridiculous that you are planning the fun aspects of your life. But if you don't put those plans into place, you kind of forget to do it and you allow yourself to get wrapped up in this whole entity of being sick. And when you plan ahead and put all these pieces into play ahead of time, you are able to have a fun, phenomenal time, even regardless that you are going through a crappy situation. But with that, with following the fun and everything else, I think this is probably my biggest advice on all of this is following your normal routine. For me, part of that was working 70 hours a week. I worked two jobs and I bartended as well. But having that basic thing that I did each week and